First thing I want to say, screen sharing, screen casting, desktop capture, whatever you want to call it, whatever term you want to use, this works on Wayland, right? I am literally using it right now. Anyone telling you it doesn't work is completely lying to you. It works. It doesn't require running OBS as root. As one person I saw said, I don't know where this idea came from. It's not true. The majority of issues with screen sharing on Wayland basically come to the application side. Tools like Discord and Zoom do now have support, but there are a lot of tools that do lag behind, notably tools that people were a big fan of, things like Simple Screen Recorder. I don't know if this is ever going to have Wayland support, but right now it doesn't. With that being said, there are issues with Wayland screen sharing, and those issues do need to be addressed. So at XDC 2025, during the Lightning Talk segment, this was uploaded a few days ago, but was recorded back in October or late September, I'm not sure exactly which day it was on, there was a talk from an NVIDIA person.
Hello everyone, my name is Dokan Korkmazturk. I'm an engineer in NVIDIA's Linux graphics team, and today I'm gonna rant about screencasting on Wayland.
And that's exactly what we're going to be doing. Maybe not ranting per se, but definitely outlining some of the problems that do exist. Now, I know what you might be thinking. This is an NVIDIA person raising issues, so clearly it's an NVIDIA-related problem. In this case, no. It has nothing to do with NVIDIA. Obviously, NVIDIA is going to be involved in screen capture because the GPU is doing all graphic stuff, but this is relevant regardless of what GPU you have. Now, regardless of which system you're on, screencasting is going to have a number of different uses. Some of those involve content creation like I'm literally doing right now. Sometimes it's streaming, it might be game streaming, it might be text streaming, it might be some other sort of streaming. It might be video conferencing, so using something like Zoom and being in a meeting, or Discord and sharing the game you're playing, things like that. Or you might have some custom solution, maybe a signboard that is showing a desktop or something else like that. These are all completely valid use cases. Application and screen previews in a desktop. So if you're trying to do marketing for KDE or for GNOME or Budgie or anything else out there, you want to be able to show what the desktop can do, and the easiest way to do that is capture the desktop and show people what it looks like. Of course, you could always use external capture methods with a capture card, but that costs extra money, and you probably have additional resources on your system that you're not using that screen capture is perfectly valid for. And of course, for software development as well, whether it's testing that a piece of GUI software actually works correctly, for debugging remote and local, so knowing that if you change something, that change is actually a valid change. And when somebody reports a bug, a lot of the times those bugs are very graphical in nature and are kind of hard to explain in text what is happening. A video of it is a great way to show off a bug. On Wayland, there are actually multiple approaches to doing screen capture. It's just we mainly talk about one of these, as this is the main supported method, that being XDG Desktop Portal and Pipewire. That is what I'm using here, it's what OBS supports, it's what you're likely using in pretty much every application, it's how Discord does it, how Zoom does it. There are other approaches though. There are approaches where you have a built-in screen capture method in the desktop. A lot of those don't make use of a portal. Instead, they're probably going to have a Pipewire backend, or they're going to have some sort of Wayland protocol. This Wayland protocol is mainly for WRoot compositors, but there are custom protocols in certain desktops that are specifically used for their screen capture tool. Now, the portal method with Pipewire technically isn't Wayland specific. You actually could use portals to do this on X11. It's just no applications are going to go through the portal because they can just ask X11 to capture the screen. So why would they go through the permission system when there's a wide open door off to the side, right? It's hard to add a permission system into something that didn't have one from the start. And there is also the KMS method. This is not what you're thinking. This is kernel mode setting. This is used by FFmpeg with KMS Grab and GPU Screen Recorder. The main problem with this is it does require elevated privileges, so it's just not really viable for most cases. You don't really want to give some random capture application elevated privileges just to capture your screen. That doesn't make any sense. And with this one being the main focus, this is the one that is mainly going to see benefits from improving. Now, one of the issues he raised is regarding explicit sync and screencasting. I don't think this is that interesting myself, so I will leave the talk linked down below if you want to hear him talk about it. The TLDR, though, is basically with explicit sync, which is something that NVIDIA kind of dragged their feet on for quite a while. It also has to be implemented at each application level as well. So it needs to be implemented in the compositor, in the drivers, and all the applications that want to be using it, which means it's a lot of additional work to make it happen. That's basically the main problem with it. Now, the main meat is regarding the permission system, and this is something where a lot of people have a lot of opinions. I have my own, and it has improved over time, but it's still got some notable problems. So when I want to start screen capturing something, let's say I go and add a new node into this. So this opens a window that looks like such. I can either select a display or select an individual window that I want to capture. Now, that is fine, and that does work. The problem is things are remembered except when they're not. So this makes use of a token-based approach. And my desktop, my individual monitors, those are captured just fine. Those are generally remembered. Sometimes they're not, in which case I need to select them again, but most of the time I can open OBS and it's fine. It's a lot more of an issue with the podcast overlay. For that one, when it's just me and a guest, I have two captures of a Discord window to actually get the cameras into the overlay, and then another capture of my browser window. Because these are opened as a new session, as a new window, these don't have any token to load from, any token to be remembered. So every time I open that overlay, a bunch of selections just suddenly appear and are like, hey, select the thing that you want to capture. What is it? I don't know. Work it out for yourself. And obviously, when I have two or three guests, the problem is even worse. So I end up just closing all those windows and then selecting each of those individual elements and then setting them after the fact. Because the other thing is the permission window doesn't actually say the element that is trying to ask for the capture. So it'll say, oh, OBS wants to capture it, but it doesn't say OBS camera 1, OBS camera 2, OBS browser, anything like that. It's all just basically spamming of the exact same window. And the same thing can be said for doing game capture, or I know people that are doing capture of their VTuber model, and it's the exact same thing. You just get spammed with a ton of capture requests, and it's impossible to work out which one is which. However, if I were to close OBS without closing any of those windows and then reopen OBS, because they are still the same window, the token is going to be valid, and usually it will reload the things I was capturing. I say usually because sometimes, like with the desktop, the token is just not saved, is not valid, there's something that goes wrong, and I need to reset things again. Now, it would be nice to know which element OBS is trying to actually attach the capture to, but besides that, asking the user what they want to capture every time they open up the application and a token is invalid, this is an improvement to security, because the old method, well, that allowed you to leak a lot of data. So on X11, if you happen to have a Discord window open, and last time it was checking for a Discord window, it just grabs the Discord window. Doesn't matter if it's the same window, if it looks the same, it's gonna grab it. Same with your browser or other things. If there is something that looks roughly like that window, on X11, OBS would just happily grab anything. However, whilst the Wayland and Pipewire and Portal approach does have some security benefits, it does have some serious drawbacks. Restricting automation and remote use cases. if you want to do some automation, if you want to do some remote capture, you need to have physical access to the machine or can talk to someone that has physical access to the machine or set things up beforehand so that everything is working. And then hope and pray that nothing breaks because there's no way to fix it again without physical access to the machine. Now, there are some hacky, janky scripts to work around this where it's basically just automating the keyboard and mouse and then trying to fiddle its way through the UI. This is very sensitive to breakage and UI changes, and it's just not a good solution. It's a hack, it's not a good long-term fix. There is a need for a common ahead-of-time permission scheme where you can say, okay, I want to have OBS be allowed to capture things. I don't need to give it permission. And the point of the speaker doing the talk is getting people talking about the problem and trying to come up with solutions to make this work in the future. Feel free to let me know your thoughts down below on what you would think to do, but this is my idea. I don't know how you would go about implementing this, but this is just what I'm thinking. So right now the tokens are on the application you're trying to capture. It's like a session token. Instead of doing it on a session, there should be a way to say, I want to go and authorize this capture application to be able to just go and capture things, whether that be OBS or Discord or Zoom or some automation application, whatever it is you want to use. Let's go with OBS. You give OBS the capture token and say, okay, OBS can go and capture whatever it wants. I don't need to confirm anything. It automatically says you're allowed to do that, but no other applications have that same permission. So Discord couldn't go and do so, Zoom couldn't go and do so. For those ones, it would go and open up the prompt and ask you like always, but OBS just gets free rein to do whatever it wants. And then once the user is done with that, they can then reject the token, and then OBS goes back to asking the user every time they want to capture something. Again, I don't know the best way you'll go and implement this. I don't know if you'd have like a config file or a token-based system or what you'd want to do for this, but I think that's probably the best approach you could take. Now, if anyone has any thoughts on this or, you know, just your experience doing Wayland screencasting, let me know. Let me know your thoughts down below. Do you have issues with the way that screen capture is done? Would you like to see improvements? Do you think it's great as it is? I'd love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video, go subscribe as well. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribes, Deli, Beripay linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me. And again, you can capture your desktop. There's just some issues with it. What is this?